हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवियन डॉक्टर अनामिका अहरवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लेक्चर ऑन द सब्जेक्ट नेम डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग एंड माइनिंग। नाउ द सेशन ऑफ टुडेज इज आर्टिफिशियल न्यूरल नेटवर्क, दैट इज ANN। These are the topics which I have covered during this session. What is artificial neural network? Basic structure of ANN, types of ANN, machine learning in ANN, applications of neural networks. So, come to what is artificial neural network. Dr. Robert Heck Nelson defines, basically he is an inventor of neurocomputer, and he defines a neural network as a computing system made up of number of simple, highly interconnected processing elements which process information by their dynamic state response to external inputs. And now comes to the basic structure of artificial neural network. The idea behind artificial neural network is totally based on the belief that working of human brain by making the right connections can be imitated using silicon and wires, living neurons and dendrites. This is also a biological term actually. As I told you in clustering genetic algorithm, this is also related to this, but this is in terms of neurons actually. This neuron forms a network, and that network is the artificially created by, okay, so we call it as an artificial neural network. So the human brain is composed of basically 86 billion nerve cells. That nerve cells are called as the neurons. Our human brain is made up of neuron cells, we all know about that. So they are connected to other 1000 cells by axons. Okay, so stimuli from external environment or input from sensory organs are accepted by dendrites. So these inputs create electronic impulses, and these impulses which quickly travel through the neural network. Okay, so a network can then send the message to other neuron to handle the issues, or does not send it forward, right? So just in general, if we are talking about that, if whatever brain works, how our brain works, that when someone talks, you suppose I am talking to you, then suppose I am talking that let's start the session of data warehousing and mining, then what your brain receives the message that okay, fine, madam teaches us this data warehousing subject, okay, so the message sends to the same here, that neuron can then send the message to other neuron, means the rest of the neurons which just inform you, okay, fine, this topic starts, so let's start for doing, okay. Now see this structure. This is the basic structure of artificial neural network. You see, this is the information transfer, okay, here, okay, these are the nerve impulses in this axons processes input as input, means decentered accept input, and this passes on, means send this message through nerve impulses, and this is collected to the in form of information, and that information is transformed. Okay, so this is the basic structure of artificial neural network. So this ANN is composed of multiple nodes which imitates biological neurons of human brains. The neurons are connected by link, and they interconnect with each other, like you see in this, these are interconnected, okay, like. So the nodes can then input data and perform simple operations on the data. The result of these operations is passed to other neurons, right? So like the result of these neurons pass to other than like a game which we are playing in our childhood, that one message passes to the other person and then that message forward to the other person, and then after that we check the message whether this message got inputted to the person, first person, and the finally the last person, the message is as the original message or not. If there's no original message, then we track for that person key from where the message loses its originality. Okay, so same here the working processes in this artificial neural network. So the result of these operations is passed to other neurons. The output at each node is called its activation or node value. So we call it as like in software engineering, we have learned about every output is the input of the other phase. Like same here, recently I am describing the, I am telling you the just example of this game, that the message passes on to the other person, then that input is the output of the other person. Okay, so that output is the input to the other. Okay, so that is called the activation, you can say, and that activation, the other name we can call it as a node value. So the each link, now see in this diagram, this is a kind of network. Each link is associated with weight. Okay, this input is associated with other and connected to every node. These nodes are hidden basically. We input this and then we get the final output. Okay, so artificial neural network are capable of learning which take place by altering weight value. The following this illustration shown in this simple figure. Okay, now come to the types of artificial neural network. There are basically two types of artificial neural network. First is feed forward and the second is feedback. Now what is feed forward artificial neural network? In this artificial neural network, the information flow in unidirectional. Unidirectional means one direction. Okay, so your units, as you can see, this information sends to this and like this, and but it is not multi, means vice versa, not possible here. So we can call it as a unidirectional, right? So a unit sends information to other unit for which it does not receive any information, right? So there are no feedback loops. There's no feedback loops. So they are used in pattern generation, recognition, or classification. So they have fixed input and outputs. Like see, they of course there's a loop, but we just send the input actually. Okay, so that's why we call it as a unidirectional. See here also, this is a unidirectional, right? Now the second is feedback artificial neural network. In this we see that this information goes to this and this information goes to this, but still that the information is revert back to this. That's why we call it as feedback, means the information sends back to. Okay, so feed forward loops are allowed. They are used in content addressable memories. Now comes to the machine learning in ANN. In this supervised learning, it involves a teacher, that is scholar, then the artificial neural network itself. Like a teacher feeds some example data about which the teacher already knows the answer. That is the supervised learning, means that is all pre-planned, or you can say trained data. Okay, so for example, pattern recognition, the artificial neural network comes up with guesses while recognizing. Then the teacher provides the artificial neural network with the answers. The network then compares it, guesses with the teacher's correct answer and makes adjustments according to the error, right? Now, if we are talking about the unsupervised learning, then it is required when there is no example data set, because it is untrained, because we are not pre-planned. Okay, so with the known means randomly some students ask the question, then suppose a teacher that time teacher was not expected that question, but still they listen and then think and then give it to the answer, but that question is not the pre-planned. If the teacher asks the questions, that means they are somehow pre-planned, because that is some sort of training set. On the if the students randomly ask or immediately ask some question back, that means that question is not pre-planned. That question might be possible that student pre-planned that. So in terms of students, can be said that it is a supervised learning. But if we are talking about the in terms of teacher, then it is unsupervised learning in this case, right? So in this case, clustering, that is dividing a set of elements into groups according to some unknown patterns, is carried out, which is based on the existing data sets present. The other is reinforcement learning. It is also some other kind of learning technique. This strategy built on observation basically. Okay, so here basically the focus on the observation. Okay, so the ANN makes a decision by observing its environment. If the observation is negative, the network adjusts its weights to be able to make a different required decision the next time. Now come to the application of neural networks. There are many applications of neural network, like aerospace, in this aeropilots, aircrafts fall detection, automotive and military, electronics, and financially, in this real estate appraiser, loan advisor, mortgage screening, etc. And in terms of industrial manufacturing process control, product design and analysis, etc. And of course, in medical also, cancer cell analysis, EEG and ECG analysis, prosthetic design, transplant time optimizer, speech, telecommunications, transportation, software, in software pattern recognition, in facial recognition, optical character recognition, etc. And the time series prediction, that is ANN, are used to make predictions on stocks and natural calamities, etc. There are so many applications of neural network. So here I wind up this session. This is a question for the practice. What is ANN? Explain the working of artificial neural network. Thank you. This session powered by digital version 2.0, Jayuti Vidyapeeth Women's University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.